like to take and call the Monday, July 16th regular select board meeting to order. To my far left is Pete Kelly, Wayne Lamberton. To my right is Angelina Capron, and I'm Brad Town. The with us is Diane Isabel, our treasurer, and Dana Hadley, our town administrator. And additions or changes to the agenda?
I have none.
Okay. Anyone else? No. Public comment? Hearing none, we'll move on. Treasurer's report.
I've given the select board the June trial balance budget status report and delinquent tax report. Last week, on the 10th, I printed the tax bills and mailed them out on the 11th and 12th. That's all I've got. It took me the whole week to get the tax bills out.
Okay. Thank you very much. Approval of license permits, vouchers, and applications.
Wait. One of us has been through the check so far, we better.
Yeah. Okay. Annual financial town plan for highways.
This is a piece of paperwork that we do every year for V-Trans. This year, I waited because of the grants that we received from V-Trans, but this needs to be approved by the board. It outlines our estimated costs of what we're going to spend for winter maintenance and for general maintenance, and what we're going to allocate to a Class 2 road and a Class 3 road. It also outlines the projects we have planned for this construction season, the paving of Fisher Road, Payne Turnpike North, Granger Road, and replacement of the culvert on Mirror Lake Road. That's it. Yeah, so I just need you to accept it and sign it so I can submit it to the state.
Did we have some money in the bridge reserve fund? Remember we're talking about, or did we use that?
No, we have some.
We do, so.
Right. I'm not sure if we're going to need to hit that for Mirror Lake. Richardson Road, probably we're going to have to go into. And right now, I can't tell you how much it is.
Okay, so I just was wondering if it wasn't in there. I mean, that's all right. I'm just checking it.
Yeah,
I didn't remember the conversation.
Right.
A motion to accept this.
Are we through it all?
There's more discussion to come, but we should have a motion in a second.
Just that first part. So I move we accept the annual financial plan for the town highways as presented.
Second. Any further discussion?
Yes. Did we order the box culvert?
No.
We did?
No, not yet.
Are we expecting the engineering to be complete?
I've been trying to talk with John Grenier. John's been on vacation, so I did call him. He's gone a couple weeks after the last meeting, and I don't have an answer, but I will by next time. I did speak with John briefly about ordering the culvert, and he thought it was premature to do that right now. This was a few weeks ago, though.
So we're basically not going to get it done this fall?
I am hopeful that, of course, we're going to get it done.
I think that John, the engineer, should call a couple of the precast people to see what the lead time is for a box culvert.
He had mentioned that he thought that was a good idea as well. So he may have done that. I don't know right for sure.
I heard 12 weeks.
Is that a way you're doing?
On the box culvert?
That would be a problem.
Mm-hmm. But I know what you're saying.
August, September.
Yeah, the box culvert's going to be fast, though.
Right, but if you don't get it till December.
Because I've had a couple. The state won't let you dig after October.
Right.
And play in the water.
Huh.
I've had a couple people ask me if it was going to help a bit.
The issue is that the permit, the fix has not been approved by the state.
I see.
And so that's one.
What I would suggest is the town order the box culvert, and then whoever wins the bid can buy it. But at least then it's ready when it's ready to be done.
Yeah.
rather than awarding the bid in September and then having them find out it's 10 or
20. So you're saying order it now and have it, and if we don't use it, we could sell it
somewhere? No, we will use it.
We'll use it.
Oh.
We're just going to have to pay for it to pre-order it this far ahead.
Right.
Then sell it to the contractor.
Right.
I see.
But in most cases, the precast company won't even make you pay for it. You just guarantee, the town's guaranteeing they're going to buy a box culvert, and then when whoever wins the bid, they can buy it.
Okay.
But they're not going to make one on, hypothetically.
Speculation.
Right. But the concern is the later you get in the year, the further back.
How big is it going to be?
I don't know.
No. What are your hydraulics?
But that isn't that with like $42,000 or something?
The engineer knows how big it's going
to
be.
Yeah. I mean, that I'd have to go to the engineer and have him.
So, Tim, if push came to shove, could you push those mounds of gravel around and throw some steel over and drive over it for the winter, or is it, it's that shot? When I walk
the problem, over the problem you're going to have is if we do that, it's just going to keep, which it's done already, it's just going to keep rolling back, and then eventually your steel's going to drop down in there.
Okay.
Because what happens is it's not so much the flow going through the air, but when the wind blows, it comes back through there, through that culvert.
Uh-huh. The wave action?
Yep.
And it just washes.
That's what caused all the problems, because we had the high winds there when it collapsed, and it just, everything went down.
Huh. Is that a school bus route?
Yes.
Yeah, but, I mean, last I knew, they were picking the kids up on Black Road.
The bus does go down and parks right there, right at the corner of Mirror Lake. I've seen him go down there. We can't go
on the bus. On the Brookfield side?
Yeah, the flat.
No, then that's their turnaround. Oh, that's as far as they go.
Because I said last time, you know, I've been walking around there every morning, because counting all the traffic, 3 today, 5 cars, you know, to even need that.
The last kids they pick up, I think, are Lagerstedt's kids right there on Belknap and at that intersection. They don't go out any further than there. But they, somebody told me that there's only one child out there right now, and they're bringing them to Black Road, and Jeremy's kids.
Yeah, I'm talking on the east side.
Yeah.
Sorry I got off track. I thought several times about this culvert, wondered if we've done anything yet. So if we could find out from John.
Okay. I probably didn't understand of buying it and then selling it to the contractor.
But I don't think we'll have to buy it. I think we would call and get 3 prices on precast concrete culverts, box culverts. Find out who's got the best price, order one, and the town would give a PO to the precast company, which they would transfer to the contractor when the contractor wanted it.
Okay.
But then you've got one.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I mean,
I think that's the difference between getting it done this year and not getting it done.
Sure. It's the middle of July.
Right.
So
I guess the only one that really inconveniences is me, a lady. She's got to come all the way back around, back up the front side.
And it's a little frustrating because it's all contingent upon a lot of factors.
Right. Well, like you say, I mean, if the state hasn't, you know, approved the plan.
We don't have the permit.
The state won't give you a waiver to work after October 1st?
We've gotten them before until November 30th. But that's the latest.
But especially if the state held it up. I mean, if the state were ready, we would be more ready ourselves, wouldn't we?
We're ready. I mean, I don't know where John is, and I really should, but we're ready to go forward. I mean, right. Financially and all other questions. So.
Now, Richardson Road, we're going with a liner, right? Still?
John hasn't given me the engineering report on that. That was the idea, that it would make sense to go with the liner.
All right. Sorry to get off track.
All right. So,
any other discussion on this? Hearing none, those in favor?
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries. Winter sand bid opening?
If I could just, there is a part 2 for this one, which the board also needs to sign the town plan, which is in addition to the financial plan, that we're guaranteeing we're spending at least $300 per mile, each mile of class one, two. We don't have, I mean, two and three highways, we don't have a class one. And we are. So, in fact, I don't want to tell you how much we're spending per mile, but.
So where does that come from?
The taxpayer money is.
No, that we're guaranteeing that we're spending $300.
It's a procedure that V-Trans has just has us do.
Okay.
And I have one more piece before you go. This is housekeeping work. Certification of compliance for town road and bridge standards. In 2014, the town adopted the town road and bridge standards and network inventory, and we are still complying with that. So it just needs to be confirmed.
Can I steal your pen? Or is that?
Can I steal somebody's pen?
There were a couple of pens on the desk that were for people to use.
Even knows how to spell my name.
You know, you're welcome to use it.
Oops, I'm sorry.
Okay, winter sand bid opening?
We received two bids for winter sand. One had a return address, so I knew who it was from, and the other did not. We're interested in keeping the score. Alright. Here are the bids.
I think that I'm going to recuse myself, not knowing who the second bidder is.
You'll learn, you don't worry.
Exactly.
That's some good teachers, right?
I'm here to help you with
that. She's all set.
David has confidence.
Tabor Earth Extractors.
Okay, so the bid is from Tabor Earth Extractors. They are proposing $10.25 per cubic yard. And I'll have to look and make sure he's got all these things in there, but. And so the bid was calling for how much per
5,000.
5,000 cubic yards. So 1025 per cubic yard.
Now, this is just sand. There's no trucking involved. Pete?
So, from Hebert Excavation in Williamstown, Vermont, their bid is $8.50 per cubic yard for winter sand. It said they wouldn't be ready to meet the order till August 15th to have the material ready for hauling.
$8.50?
Yes.
I see. Okay.
I was looking at it and going, $10.25 for what? But now I see, now I see 5,000 cubic yards.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Got it.
The only problem I have is we got our sand from Larry last year, and it wasn't good sand.
Well, I should have
a lot of trouble.
I should have finished. Also enclosed is a recent test of our material by the land test.
I don't care what he's got for tests.
So what does rotten sand mean? It's too rocky?
No, it's too much dirt in it. We had a hard time getting it to go through our sanders. The first year we got it from them was good. But last year, we had a fight with it all winter long. The guys had to keep getting out and kicking their chutes to get it to drop down onto the spinners. There wasn't as much rock in it. And if you sanded and we got just a little bit of flurry activity, it just glazed right over. It was icy. So we had to sand again.
Does he know that?
Well, I haven't talked to him. No.
That might have been a good idea. Tell him.
He enclosed
the testing.
A testing form. Because we did specify some criteria that we were looking for.
That's my only complaint, but I haven't. I talked with Larry earlier this year, but they hadn't started doing anything out there. It's not his pit. He gets his sand from Ed Farnham. And it's not a pit. They just dig a big hole and extract the sand, and then when you're done, they fill it in.
Can we table this and have you find out anything about that, or is it worth it?
Well, I mean, we got to buy it from somewheres, but
right.
I mean,
but
that's
$2 a difference.
Yeah. It's a $10,000.
Yeah, it's a fair amount.
Just under $10,000. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Difference.
And it's probably going to cost more to get it trucked from Grosses or Tapers because they're a little further away.
Air in Northfield.
Mm-hmm. I mean, cheapest isn't always cheapest, but $10,000.
Plus additional mileage for trucking.
Right.
Probably.
I don't know that for sure, but I mean, it's definitely further than.
I mean, I think that probably the only thing that we could do is to speak with Mr. Hebert about the quality,
because I think he should know if no one complains.
Well, last year I think that there was us and Brookfield came in and bought some from him, and Norfield bought it, but they bought it in October because they didn't put it out to bid, mm-hmm. and they just gave it to somebody, and the taxpayers over there said, whoa, anything over $5,000 got to go out to bid, same policy that we have here. So they ended up had to put it out to bid, so it was the end of October when they got it. So.
So does that makes a difference?
No, they didn't have much choice. They had to get the sand because it was getting close to winter.
Right, I see. Okay.
So.
When do the pits close?
Huh?
When do the pits close?
Larry hauled sand to Norfield in January.
Yeah.
So, I mean.
So are we up against a deadline if we take another 2 weeks?
Well, it's getting late, so.
I mean, all I can think of what we would do is just tell him that his product
I can go down there tomorrow and look at
for.
It. I know Plainfield went and looked at it because they're having a hard time finding sand. And he called me because Larry used me as a reference. And he didn't like it. He said he could pick it up and make it
stick it together.
Yep.
That's what we would be buying.
Well, I don't know. I haven't been down there. But he was down there because he called when I was on vacation, and then he called me when I got back.
When they dig these holes and extract the sand, do they dig the holes next to each other, or are they taking?
They're digging.
Or they do an excavator?
And they dig down with an excavator. They strip the top off, take the topsoil off, and And then he just digs down with an excavator and screens it.
Oh.
And then Williamstown has their pit just over the knoll there from them, and they have all kinds of fill, so they got to get rid of it out of their pit. So they're hauling it over there and dumping it in the hole so they can fill it back in, because that way you don't have to deal with them, Shaw, because it's not a pit.
Oh, great recognition.
So you want to wait?
Motion to table to next meeting?
Motion to table.
I had gone around and looked at some. LePage's has got good sand, but he got a bid cheap. And when I talked to him down here, I went to East Montpelier because they bought sand from him last year, and it is good sand. And he said he doesn't like the bid, but they got a bid sheet, and I talked with his son last week, and he said, I think we're going to bid, but they didn't.
We missed the deadline.
And they were $850, because he told me what he gets. He said, I don't bid. It's $850 if you like it or not.
Oh, well.
But
that's okay.
He didn't bid, so.
So even if you call it, so it's too late now to get sand from this guy?
No, it's not too late. It's just we got to do it.
Well, it is sort of too late.
Because
you'd have to rebid it.
Right. Maybe I'll read this on top of the price.
Right.
That's my point.
Yeah. So, I don't know, spending a little while to find out if he can get us something better than last year, I think it's worth a little bit of time.
It's probably partially my fault because I didn't say anything to him after last year, but I went over and looked at it, and they had just stripped, so they didn't have any sand screen when I was over there.
But nothing's going to change between now and 2 weeks, is it?
It's 2 weeks further along.
Well, he can't do anything. He can't do anything until August, anyways.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I motion to table until the next meeting. Oh, he's recusing himself. So
we need a second.
Okay, a second.
Should be
a
second.
All right.
Any other discussion? All in favor of tabling until next select board meeting?
I can go over and talk to him.
I mean, he can't change what he can't change, but we might.
Oh, I don't know. The first year we got it from him, it was awesome.
Gotta come from there then.
Yep. Same place. Well, it was in a
little further old.
It was in a different section of the field, but they can't dig anymore there because they're too close to somebody's
Well, in case DuBois or Newton was the other bidder, I'd recuse myself, but now that they're not, I guess I can be involved.
Yeah. So. Well, they may be the haulers.
Which I'll recuse myself.
Which we do need to speak about that, so.
Now would be a good time.
If this is a good time, let's talk about it. So Wayne probably will have to recuse himself. Our vendor last year was Jeff Newton for hauling. He has offered to extend the contract for the same cost we paid last year. And we have the ability to do that if you so desire.
Well, if we do that, we're taking a risk that somebody may bid lower.
That's true.
And if he's going to take an if he wants to extend it,
can we do that?
Well, can I say something?
Sure thing.
We did the same thing with the gravel. We said that if the outfit that's furnishing the gravel would stay the same, that we would continue buying it. Northeast held their price the same, and so did Jeff. I can tell you right now, you're not going to get anybody to haul it cheaper than Jeff Newton. Because we've gone through this and everybody else has always been way higher. There's the trucking part of this is getting slim to none.
Yeah.
I mean, Tim Stone's only got two trucks now, and Larry Grattan's down to
equipment.
Larry Grattan's down to one truck. He had three at one time. It's just there's Adam Stone's the only other one that, and he bid higher.
So we can just roll it over?
Apparently so.
Yeah.
Okay.
It just.
I mean, we can put it out to bid if you'd like me to do that.
Well,
the only other thing I got to say is it's our time too. It's not as much as it is getting somebody to haul it here.
Yeah.
When you got 8-10 trucks hauling in this dooryard, and it's tractor trailers or five of them, it's less time that I've got to have somebody over here putting it up. A lot less time. I mean, we did 5,000 yards of sand in no time flat last year.
So in the bid, could you put a time limit on it?
Don't really have to. I mean, because if they're not going to haul, they always let me know they have no trucks today coming.
I see.
So I don't have somebody sitting over here. I mean, they all do that. Mm-hmm. When McCullough used to haul our sand, and we bought from them, I mean, all they had was two trucks, and it took all summer to put it up. It takes a long time, just a couple of trucks.
We gotta cross this decision until we get to get sick. Actually, we should, because we need to know how far it's going to be to haul sand.
Right, we don't know for sure where we're getting from.
Yeah.
Well, gravel is sitting there waiting to get hauled, and I could use it.
Oh,
that's what we're mainly talking about with
just Jeff. Just gravel,
but hauling right now.
I move we continue the agreement with the Newton Trucking.
Okay, I second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Those opposed?
What? Sorry.
In favor?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Aye. Okay. Sorry.
Motion carries.
Thank you.
So when it comes to the sand, we'll have taken top trucking again.
So what if you go look at the sand and it's awful stuff? What are we going to do?
I'll go tomorrow. And to me, it's costly for us because we went through a lot of sand last winter. It's time involved.
Sure.
So much we had to go back and sand.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I don't know if we'd have to rebid it if somebody will outright sell it for the same price as a low bid.
I have to get a hold of Rob on that one.
Mm-hmm.
I just think that because they didn't bid
in a short distance too.
Right.
Yeah, I'm not saying we shouldn't buy it. I'm just saying because they didn't bid by the deadline.
Yeah.
I think we have to refuse the bids to entertain another price. But we should check.
Yeah, I just have to get a feel for this from Rob. And
okay. See. Well, I'll do that.
But it'll be a mute point if Tim goes down since good sand.
Yeah, I mean, I've been busy and I've been gone, so I didn't get a chance to get out there. But I know what Mike told me from Plainfield did.
So we are talking about the other vendor you were talking about that gave you a price that did not bid.
Yeah, that's a short haul.
That's just up the beltway.
Yeah.
Okay. Got it.
Because you're gonna save money in trucking, I think. I think it was $4 and something a yard to truck it last year. Is that something that you
could
look?
Yeah, I've got it.
I'm pretty sure it was four something from Ebert's. Because they're just the other side of Pike's Pit on Route 14 going down to Williamstown.
Okay, quote on hose machine.
That would be Tim as well.
hydraulic hose machine. We got more times that we can't get a hose. And twice Tate helped us out at Berrytown at 9 or 10 o'clock at night to keep us on the road plowing last winter. And, it's just to run down here and get a hose made when we could do it ourselves. Yeah. I think it would pay for itself.
So you just would keep inventory?
Well, I mean, like, when I was at Marshfield, we bought our own hose machine because we were way out in East Padunk. And we just kept 100 feet of each size hose that we needed.
What size hoses do you run those trucks?
3/4, 1/2, and 3/8. Mainly.
And what are the fittings you're going to need for it?
Well, that's the thing. They wanted to sell me a whole
array
of fittings, and I said, no, I don't want that. I mean, if I had four or six fittings of each size.
And
45, and of course, Cat's all GC, and then...
Oh, JIC?
JIC, I mean.
Yeah.
And John Deere is flat O-ring.
Flat face, yeah.
Yeah, flat face O-ring. So, I mean...
A handful of each.
Yeah.
In three different sizes.
You know, just like the loader broke down last winter, blew a hose. We couldn't load no more trucks, so we couldn't do nothing.
You sure inch 3/4 and a half?
No, 5/8 and a half. There's a few 3/8 on the loader, but very, very, very minimal. So, I mean,
nothing so much that, but how many inch hoses do you have?
The ones that run are from the pump to the
valve
tower, and then another one to the sander controls. That's inch. And then most of your main lines for the dump body and all that stuff is 3/4, and then your sander stuff is all 1/2 inch.
So what's the price of this machine?
$2,300. And got another guy that approached me at the truck show at Berry Auditorium, and he sells hose machines. It's called Midwest, and it's totally different. So I'm not going to be able to buy fittings around here. So I mean, I'm going to have to order everything and make sure I got plenty. And
so which one were you going with, Gates?
Yeah, Gates is the most common.
And that's the $2,300.
Normally you get 3 quotes for amounts under $5,000. In this case,
he wanted $2,500.
Right, you had two
for this guy,
23, and then you had $2,500, and we weren't sure how convenient getting
his cell phone is Baton Rouge, Louisiana, so.
Whereas here, you could go down to Sunel and get what you needed.
I think that makes a lot of sense. Mm-hmm.
If you ran out of one fitting. Yeah. Who was the vendor for the fittings?
Sunel's.
It's going to be Sunel.
That makes sense to me.
Yeah.
That one hose you need at midnight, Saturday night, would be worth $2,300 by Monday. Yeah. I'll move that we approve the purchase of the hose machine.
Second.
And when I worked for Iroquois, I've made hoses. And we didn't have a Gates, but they're all pretty basic. But in Marshfield, we had a Gates hose machine.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries. Approval of select board minutes for 5/21/2018. We have a form of that.
Yes. Jeremy was the only one absent of that meeting.
Right.
Move to approve the minutes as printed for the select board meeting of May 21st.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Approval of select board minutes for 6/4/2018. We have a quorum for that.
We do, yeah.
That was not only Jeremy.
Jeremy was not present.
I move we accept the select board minutes for June 4th, 2018 as presented.
Seconded.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
You cannot do the next one.
Jeremy's not here. You would need, there are only three of us. Were you here for that?
Yep.
Were there four?
No, it was just you and I and then Jeremy on the phone.
Yeah.
So I'll have to hold over.
I'll bring that one back to you.
Town administrator's report, David.
I have a few things. Late this afternoon, I did get an email from Michael Miller. Michael is the director of planning community development for the city of Montpelier. And Montpelier is, and I'm just, since I got this at 4:10, I haven't really digested it, but they have applied for a grant to do a rail study between Montpelier and Barrie for transportation.
For people?
For people.
Yeah.
And so they are, I will go ahead and forward this to you tomorrow so you can read it. And they're asking for a letter of support for the grant. So I guess I will bring it back to you next time. But that this came in this afternoon, and I'll forward that to you. We did get a letter from the town of Barrie because in July we have a new ambulance rate, which is as per the per the contract. So that's nothing, no surprises there. They are reminding us that this is our last contract year. We do have an option to renew the ambulance contract for 2 years, and they've given us the prices that they would do that. This is a letter that comes every July. I was asked by Barrie Town Thunder Chickens. They are working on rejuvenating or doing some new trails, snowmobile trails. He is going to give me some more information, but what I have so far, it's basically two areas, one going from Applebee's, getting over to the Irish Hill trails, and one starting in the lot between Shaw's and Comstock Road, getting to the same location. They both involve using town roads, which we eliminated the snowmobile ordinance 2 years ago, a year and a half ago. It is illegal to ride a snowmobile on a town highway unless it's a 90-degree
crossing.
When I have more information, I'll bring that back to you. But that would require, if the board wanted to support that.
Who would they be running on town roads?
They want to use Black Road, which is a Class 4 road. You may have heard of it. They also want to use they also want to use Brookfield Road to get out to the Irish Hill.
Yeah, but how are they going to get from Applebee's to there? They're going to have to run across that road.
Well, that is the other issue. Part of it would involve this property, going across this property.
So what they want to do is they want to come right over by your shed from Applebee's, come through this parking lot, probably go over by Mike Doniak's.
Yeah, but how are they going to get there, though?
I don't know.
They got wheels on those things?
They're not going to get down through that depth.
No.
They talked to me about it.
One of the guys talked to me, and he said something about coming out through and then going out here on Crosstown up as far as Payne Turnpike South, going up over the back of Tinker Lawrence's son's yes. house out through the Black Road and then out Brookfield Road. Because Northfield's involved in it too, because they're trying to get so that people can get over here.
Well, they're trying to get to North, over so to Northfield.
Northfield yes. Road all the way over to Fox?
No, they'll ride over and then.
Oh, up where they're logging.
Yes. They'll go yeah. up over Irish Hill and come down by Ellie's Farm Market.
I see.
So.
But that's the city of Montpelier's land, and I know that they've been talking with.
Well, going across people's land, I mean, they would have to get the owner's yeah, well, permission. But
supposedly they've got permission from Tinker's son, and then they're going to go on to Josh Walker's, and he's one of them that's trying
well,
to.
Well, he's working
stuff.
On it.
Yeah.
I would ask them to come in and explain what, where they were going, but it is quite a bit of. Travel on town roads.
Like visual aids.
Visual aids are always good.
Well, I mean, Crosstown's not
a, it's not a great
a good
road
because
for
they're going to be in the road until they get up past.
The other thing is, Tom's, a lot of these roads are paved. I don't see them.
Yeah.
You know, one of the machines.
I'm concerned about coming through our driveway.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're getting pretty residential.
So, quick back in, on the trains, do we have any liability for that that runs through the train grant?
That no, that's all. The train, that's all railroad property.
Right.
That's nothing to us.
So Montpelier's getting a grant.
Well, I think what Montpelier and Barrie want to do is have the, they used, is, they used to have a
shuttle thing.
Yeah, with the train to go back and forth. And I think they're trying to get that started up again.
They're saying that they're thinking of the three communities will be connected with a number of continuously operating rail buses to shuttle people back and forth. Being separated from the road, it will operate faster than fighting through the traffic.
What's being separated from the road? How do you get to where you're going when you get off the train?
Well, either they stop at the station out behind City Hall in Barrie, yeah. in Barrie,
and
not
there.
And they go to the new transit center a month later, right?
Yeah.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
I would guess.
And I don't know what they would do for Berlin unless they did something on Partridge Farm or...
They could do it at, they could do it at Price Chopper.
Yeah.
They are talking about doing something at Price Chopper.
A stop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a track from Maryland in that parking lot. I forgot about that.
Hmm. But
oh,
I haven't
had
that.
Now, where it crosses behind the shopping center, that's on the other side of the river, right?
Mm-hmm. Actually, right where you just as you start up the hill and on yeah. the Partridge Farm.
But Rubber Bubbles, right, it would be on this side of the river.
Right,
yeah. Yeah.
Right. Right around there before it crosses the street.
Crosses yeah. the railroad bridge at the old Tower restaurant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You just can see that plan.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
yeah. Well, they've been running some cars
with
granite on it. Right.
Well, there was discussion of some gentleman that bought the Bud cars. And those
are all up on Bombardier.
Yeah, they're all up in the Bombardier place.
Well, they put a lot of
those old passenger cars they had.
Yeah,
the
you know,
Christmas
they're self-contained.
Oh, these get from here.
Yeah.
When really? They got new subway cars, he bought the electric
yeah.
Trains that are up at the old Bombardier.
So can those be converted just to cars?
Well, I think that they could convert the engine to diesel.
Yeah, they're self-contained car, the engines and the car. Yeah. So it's, would that be a train? I don't know.
Oh, so it's just one car?
Yeah.
I think you'd see a lot of people use it, to be honest with you.
Well, years ago, they used to run a Christmas train from the old station in Montpelier to the one in Barrie.
Mm-hmm.
And that one done pretty good. I mean, I took our kids on it. That was pretty good until the train fell off the track.
Yeah. That could be a problem.
But they've put a lot of money into that. The tracks.
Well, they have to.
This one, I've
granite.
Seen them.
Yeah,
they can
haul the granite.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it sounds like it really is.
Anything else, Dana?
So, no, that's all I have.
You got on that?
Yeah.
Okay, approval of license permits, vouchers, and applications.
I'll move to approve general fund payable warrant 19G02 with checks 18242 to 18277 in the amount of $58,951.91, as well as payroll warrant 19-01 for payroll from June 24th, 2018 to July 7th, 2018 in the amount of $42,643.19, as well as June 2018 general journal and tax admin entries and adjustments, and the 2018 bank statement reconciliations for general fund, sewer commission, and water division.
Second. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. And round table, Pete?
No, thank you. No.
Wayne?
No.
Angela? And any executive session?
Yes, please. I need an executive session for contract.
Okay.
That's it.
Thank you.